Bam! Mr. True. Okay, let's revisit that unit circle and start evaluating some trig functions that we can figure out. 16 of the basic trig functions, well, there's 6 trig functions and 16 angles, and use these two in cooperation to answer some questions to set up some trig values and keep them in exact form. We don't need to use a calculator, and most of your pre-calc and your trig teachers should not be allowing to use a calculator on these questions. Because, you know, we don't want it just a decimal that you get punched out of a calculator. That's not going to show us that you know this and understand this unit circle. So any trig or pre-calc question that's based off of or uses one of these 16 angles, or some half and double angles when you learn those identities, but right now we're just using these 16 angles, they should be left in exact form. That means no decimals. Like, if the answer is square root of 2, leave it square root of 2. Don't make it 1 point da-da-da-da-da with all the run-on decimals. We got, when you set up your unit circle, don't forget that you count all the way around you by 30 degrees, and then all the way around using 45 degrees. Or, if you're doing radians, pi over 6 and pi over 4. That'll give you all 16 angles that you need for the unit circle. Also remember that besides the quadrantal angles, which we just identify easily as moving to the right or left one unit or up and down one unit from the origin, we do not need a triangle, nor can we set up a triangle for those four angles. The only angles that we can set up triangles for are the 12 angles, each of which you find 3 in each quadrant. And there is only 2 triangles setting up this entire unit circle, the 60-30 triangle and the 45-45 triangle. That is why you see all these repeating coordinates and why they all look so familiar. The only difference is, as we can see in this orange and yellow one, in quadrant 1, both the x and the y coordinate are positive, and in quadrant 4, where we rotate 330 degrees or 11 pi over 6 radians, we're using the same 30-60 triangle, but since we're down in quadrant 4, the y value is negative, and thus the same triangle can set up actually not just 2, but 4 different angles. Okay, let's move on to evaluating some of these trig functions. Sine of theta is y over r, cosine of theta is x over r, tangent of theta is y over x, and so on. I'm sure you can read the rest of these. Please note that in a trig function, you put in an amount of rotation, either degrees or radians, and you get out the sides of a triangle. Okay, so in an angle, out a triangle, with your 6 trig functions. Let's evaluate a couple. So let's say that we have the cosine of pi over 3. You'll have to remember that soon that pi over 3 is 60 degrees. You'll also need to remember, forgot one thing. We are talking about evaluating these trig functions, and these trig functions work out to be the same regardless of the size of the circle, but I've set up a unit circle. So when you set up a unit circle, your r values are always going to be the value of 1. That's the definition of a unit circle. And so if we're holding the r value to be a value of 1 on the unit circle, the cosine is just going to be the x coordinate, and the sine is going to be just the y. As such, I've identified it here in green. So the cosine of pi over 3, or the cosine of 60 degrees, is just the x coordinate, 1/2. Let's say the opposite direction, the cosine of negative pi over 3. Well, positive rotations go in a counterclockwise direction from 0, the positive x-axis, and negative pi over 3 goes in a clockwise direction. So negative pi over 3 is going to land you down here at negative 60 degrees, or, as you can see what I'm pointing to, negative pi over 3 is the same as 5 pi over 3, or 300 degrees. Those are coterminal angles, or separated by 360, or 2 pi. At any rate, it's still going to be the same value of 1/2. So, are you always going to get the same answer when you take a trig function of an opposite angle like this? Well, no. It's not going to work for sine. The sine of pi over 3 is the y value at 60 degrees, which is square root of 3 over 2. And the sine of negative pi over 3, again, that clockwise rotation as opposed to counterclockwise rotation, is going to be negative square root of 3 over 2. Right there. So why? Because sine is based off of the y coordinate, and when you're in down in quadrants 4 or quadrants 3 and 4, but my angle's in quadrant 4, your y value is going to be negative, and thus your sine value is going to be negative. We will be learning later that the cosine function is an even function. When you actually show you here, when you plug in opposite values of x, you get the same value of y. So if you're not sure what even functions are, you can search my type an even and odd function in my search window, or just even function or odd function, and you'll find a video for that. When you plug in negative or opposite values of x, you get the same value for y. With the sine function, you plug in negative values of x or theta, and you get out opposite values of y. Now, I'm not saying x and y in terms of the unit circle. I'm just saying it's sort of like, I should be saying, probably say domain and range. You plug in opposite values of domain, you got the same value for the range. You plug in opposite values for the domain, you get opposite values for range. This is odd, and this is an even function. Okay, let's take a look at tangent. The tangent of theta is y over x, so let's say, let's find the tangent of 4 pi over, let's say 3. Okay, 4 pi over 3, that's 1 third, 2 thirds, 3 thirds, 4 thirds. Anything with a divisor of 3 is a multiple of 60 degrees. So 160, 260, 360, 460. Tangent is y, which is negative square root of 3 over 2, over x, which is negative 1 half. And you guys, my students have seen me do this, but when you have a fraction over a fraction, the bottom one is going to flip up. So that's because you can't really divide fractions. You have to multiply by the reciprocal of the second fraction. Well, the second one is the denominator. So negative square root of 3 over 2 over negative 1 half becomes negative square root of 3 over 2 times negative 2 over 1. The 2's cancel out, the negatives cancel out, and you get a final answer of square root of 3. Now, okay, that's good. And let's remember, I picked an angle in quadrant 3. Now, tangent's y over x. So in quadrant 3, both your x coordinate and your y coordinate are going to be negative, and thus your tangent in quadrant 3 is going to be positive. So make sure you get that positive answer. Let's pick another angle measure. Let's find the tangent of 270 degrees. I just went from radians to degrees now for you. We are using all these off the unit circle, by the way. So we know if we're looking at degrees or radians, if you're using your calculator, and it would not be for one of these 16 angles, but if you're using your calculator, the only time you have to worry about what degree or what mode your calculator is in, degree or radians, is when you're touching one of these three buttons. Otherwise, it doesn't make any difference. But if you're using sine, cosine, or tangent, make sure you're in the proper mode. And for those previous questions, again, if they were not one of the 16 on the unit circle, you'd have to be in radian mode, and now we have to be in degree mode. Okay, anyway, the tangent of 270 is y over x, so it's negative 1 over 0. We can't divide by 0, and that's going to happen. Dividing by 0 is a possibility with your four quadrantal angles, 90, 180, 270, or 360. Or you could all go in the opposite direction, any coterminal angle of those quadrantal angles. So tangent, cosecant, secant, and cotangent, these all four of these trig functions has a possibility of occasionally being undefined. So make sure you pay attention to that and you know that you cannot divide by zero. When we go to graphing trig functions, these are going to be where you get your vertical asymptotes, but we're not there yet. Sine and cosine will never become undefined because they have divisors or denominators of r. And a circle cannot have a radius of zero, otherwise it's just a point. And we wouldn't be talking about these trig functions. All right, bam! Let's do a few in reverse. Let's do some inverse trig functions. But first, let's pick an example first. So let's say we want to take a look at the cosine of 135. Okay, well, the cosine of 135 is the x value, negative square root of 3 over 2. Now, excuse me, that's negative square root of 2 over 2. Now, what if I said, what's the inverse cosine? Actually, let's put it this way. The cosine of theta is equal to negative square root of 3, negative square root of 2 over 2. Now, we can see in the previous answer, the completed equation, the cosine of 135 is negative square root of 2 over 2. But what if I left the theta empty? What if I wanted to find out what angle measure gave me a cosine value of negative square root of 2 over 2? Well, I would apply the inverse cosine to both sides of the equation, and theta would be the inverse, with a little negative 1, the inverse cosine of negative squared 2 over 2. Now, in a regular trig function, you put in an angle measurement and you get out the sides of a triangle. With an inverse trig function, and we'll be doing a video of this really hitting this hard later. Right now, I'm just kind of giving you a preview. The inverse cosine of negative squared 2 over 2, see, I have the sides of the triangle and I want the angle, so I need an inverse trig function for that. Looking on the unit circle, what angle gives me a cosine value of negative squared 2 over 2? Well, there's an x value of negative squared 2 over 2, so we're getting the 135 that I started the problem off originally, but there's another point that has a cosine value, an x value of negative squared 2 over 2, and that's 225 degrees, or 5 pi over 4. So, that's all great and dandy, but let me just give you another preview of what's coming up. If you were to put that into your calculator, and it was in degree mode, the calculator would only be able to give you 135 degrees. That's because calculators and computers, especially calculators, I'm sure there might be some computer program that'll handle this, but calculators can only deal with functions. That means that when you plug in an x, it can only give you one y. So be aware that when we get to starting to use our calculator to do inverse trig functions, we may not necessarily get the answer that we want. Or all of the answer. Excuse me, all of the answers. And there's more answers to this question. I'm just giving you answers that are between 0 and 360. You know, we can spin around this unit circle and start talking about coterminal angles and say, well, there's an indefinite number of times I'm going to have an x value of negative squared 2 over 2. So we have to restrict where we want our answers from, so that you don't just keep writing for the rest of your life trying to fill up all the answers of the inverse cosine of square root of 2 over 2. Okay, bam, all right, let's move it on to another one. Let's take a look at one of these reciprocal functions. These functions are not going to be on your calculator, by the way. So if you're asked for a cosecant, secant, or cotangent, you'll have to pay special care on how to use your calculator, or if it's one of these 16 angles, you know, of course, do it with the unit circle. So that's what we're going to do right now. The secant of negative 7 pi over 6. Okay, so we have a negative angle measure, so that means clockwise rotation, and it's in radians, so it has a divisor of 6, so that's multiples of 30. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, negative 7 pi over 6. Now if you take negative 7 pi over 6 and you add 2 pi, you will get 5 pi over 6. These are coterminal angles. Cosecant is r over x, so it's the reciprocal of the x coordinate. That means it's negative 2 square root of 3. You know we're never going to be happy with radicals in the denominator, so we're going to multiply top and bottom by the square root of 3, get negative 2 square root of 3 over 3. And that's an example of how to find one of the reciprocal functions on the unit circle. I'm Mr. True. That's the unit circle. Bam! Go do your homework.